Obasanjo is a father to me, he's a father to the president, he's a father to virtually all of us in this country. And I have immense respect for him and affection, and I always will, regardless of whatever his political affiliation may be. If he made his choice, I will not cast aspersions on that choice. I disagree with that choice. I believe he should have stayed with us. I believe that, you know, it would have been better for him to stand firm and to help to ensure that the house that he built stands strong and goes from strength to strength. But he, for reasons best known to himself, made his choice and he decided to pull out. He didn't go to any other party. He decided to pull out, and that's fair enough. It's his choice and he's entitled to it. But I'll tell you this much. He has taught those of us that were taught, you know, that were his disciples or that are his disciples, enough for us to pick up the baton and to stand firm and to run the race and to win that race. And that's what we're trying to do
now. Were you disappointed in that decision former President Obasanjo?
Look, whenever a father decides that he's so upset with his children that he's going to hands off, of course it's upsetting. It's upsetting not just to me. I'm sure there are many people,
and perhaps disappointing,
across
it?
Party lines, that it's very upsetting. But at the same time, I have to respect his choice. What is important to me as somebody that's playing a key role in this presidential campaign, and my job is to ensure that President Goodluck Jonathan is returned to power. My vision right now, my focus right now, is to ensure that we achieve our objectives. After we have defeated Buhari and those that support Buhari, we will now go back to President Obasanjo and appeal to him and beg him to come and join us again and to give us the counsel and advice that
you
believe we
so
badly.